In this story, we are going to delve into the tale of Gonjiam Asylum. This asylum is in the west corner of South Korea, near the city of Gwangju in Gyeonggi Province, south of the capital Seoul. Gonjiam Asylum is named after the small town in which the hospital is located. Gonjiam Psychiatric Hospital has been called one of the most haunted places in South Korea. So much so that multiple media outlets have covered this hospital and claim it to be one of the most haunting sites in the world. Though it is easy to understand why many may think as such, when you see certain images of the structure and how quickly the decaying process has consumed this building, it is not hard to see why the building is infamous for these reasons. Gonjiam is infamous for being the most haunted place in South Korea. This hospital has attracted a lot of attention both in Korea and abroad due to its decrepit appearance and horrific stories of tortured patients and mad doctors. So much so that in 2018, a Blair Witch Project style of horror film was produced in reference to the asylum and at the location of Gonjiam itself. There is no specific date or year when the hospital was built, but based on the architectural design on the building, it is alleged that the building was constructed in post-war period in Korea around the 1950s to 60s, or possibly even later. An easy giveaway is the design of the building with its plain concrete structure and metal-framed windows. This asylum has no signs of elaborate decoration of any sort on the outside the building or in the grounds, which is a sure sign of the period in which the asylum may have been built. As many older asylums were a dark place for those whom enter its confines, but the facade of these hospitals usually contradicts the fact, especially regarding Western-style asylums. However, Gonjiam does not fall under this category of psychiatric hospitals, and it already has an eerie aura about it, making the building even more unwelcoming to the feeble-minded. Unfortunately, this asylum hasn't been well documented, and a lot of the information regarding this hospital is mainly focused on the horror aspect of the building. A lot of the original information and documents for this hospital are either in Korean or have been long lost. This insinuates the idea that this hospital was not particularly well organized, or some details may have been a bit more on the quiet side as far as administration and records of the staff and patients that once worked and attended this hospital. Or it could be a more modest matter of the hospital suddenly needing to up and leave and move out in a short period of time. During the hospital's prime, there would have been a couple of hundred patients living at the facility at one time. Patients would have been confined to double rooms, living with one or two other patients to one room. Questions surrounding whether there was overcrowding in the hospital at any point in time is unknown. Judging by the layout and size of the grounds of the hospital, we can confidently assume that the hospital was not self-sufficient, as many Western psychiatric hospitals were. The farther away from society the mentally insane are from the rest of society, the better. However, Gonjiam is in amongst what appears to be a spread out city. Considering the landscape of Korea is quite mountainous, and with Gonjiam situated on the slope of a mountain, it is concealed by the dense forest that surrounds the premises. Another easy assumption we can make is, in terms of medical equipment used at this hospital, it would have been quite basic. There has been no photo documentation of a theatre room. Most of the sinister photos coming from this hospital are to do with the exterior, corridors, or the mould and dust-filled patient quarters. This point can be confirmed due to the number of people trespassing the property and the lack of a surgery theatre or photos including doctor's rooms. This indicates that there were no such facilities at this psychiatric hospital. This can also reiterate the fact that the hospital is not so old in terms of how long the hospital may have been in operation for. It could have easily been open for only a couple of decades. In contrary, this also does not confirm whether, if in fact, there were more advanced hospital equipment in this hospital. We cannot be positive whether the owner of the hospital, or whom bought it after its closure, sold all the equipment inside, though it is easy to see, judging by the condition in which the hospital was left in, it appears that whomever the last did not take their time in leaving and most likely just up and left the place. Hence, some places look as though it had been left the way it had been when the hospital closed. Also, many of the facilities at Gonjiam consist of patients' rooms, offices, and living and recreation quarters for the patients and not much else. As the rumours go, patients were disappearing or most likely murdered by a crazed doctor who was performing experiments on the patients, leaving them to rot in their rooms, dispose of their bodies somewhere on the hospital grounds, before escaping authorities to America and leaving the asylum as it is. However, unfortunately, this is far beyond the truth. As fascinating as it may be that this is what led to the hospital's collapse, I'm unbegrudged to inform you that Gonjiam closed for more mundane reasons. The building began to have maintenance issues such as problems with sewage and the plumbing was getting old and was needing replacement. There were also concerns about the unsanitary conditions in which the hospital was kept in. The hospital was beginning to struggle financially already and with much needed repairs on the building, this added to the list of problems for the hospital. After a few years, the hospital was not able to keep up with the financial demands and the owner decided to try and sell the property with not much success and just left the structure and the property as is. The structure was left abandoned in 1995. Though there has been no specific date and the year could be off, but nonetheless, the building was definitely abandoned in the 90s. The easiest clues as to when the hospital may have closed is a calendar that was found on the floor of the hospital with the year 1995. But of course, this can only be misleading, but we don't know whether the calendar was there prior to the closure of the building or if it was brought in, the question remains. This can also be attributed to the graffiti found all over the walls, with the earliest of dates recorded being the early 2000s. From when trespassers discovered the hospital after its closure. Unfortunately, the stories that you hear about this hospital are nothing less than urban legend, though it does spark one's interest into the morbid past of this asylum. Since the release of the film Gonjiam Haunted Asylum in 2018, despite the asylum being closed to the public and fenced off with barbed wire, Gonjiam's visitors have increased significantly. Going back even further, the owner of Gonjiam Asylum had filed a lawsuit against the filming company due to the film possibly having a negative impact on the property. However, a Seoul court in late March 2018 ruled in favour of the film being shown.
Locals of Gonjiam also complained about the number of trespassers increasing, taking risks, and some even going to hospital after injuring themselves whilst attempting to enter the building. Because of this, locals refused to give tourists, ghost hunters, and urban explorers directions to the asylum and strongly encouraged them to not go there as it disturbed the community surrounding the old hospital. But of course, the locals were ignored and the curious were lured by the hospital's supposed dark history, which continued to attract even more visitors every year.
Unfortunately, it was reported that a few months after the release of the film Gonjiam Haunted Asylum, that the hospital was demolished in early to mid-2018. Though this is not the end that you may have anticipated for this asylum, but maybe there could be a lesson that we could all learn from Gonjiam's story. And even though Gonjiam no longer exists physically, we now have a story to share about this once iconic horror tourist destination, if it could be called as such.
Thank you for watching. I hope you found this story interesting. What fascinated you most about Gonjiam Asylum? Please share your thoughts and opinions down in the comments below. And if you'd like to see more of these stories, please give this video a like. And until next time, have your teapots ready for the next cup of dark tea.